The news wasn't sent across the wire. No world leader had to use the hotline.
But the fact is, Wellsville was on the verge of a crisis that threatened to wipe out the legend of a superhero.
It all started when Artie, the strongest man in the world, was tricked into leaving town, leaving behind his all-time best friend. They were both betrayed by this man, a man we call Dad.
Pete didn't have the heart to tell you himself. That's why he asked me to do it. He wants you to go.
Oh, Doc! Hold me!
Dad, a simple man in a complicated situation. Easy prey for the international adult conspiracy and a supervillain known as John McFlemp, a master salesman of aluminum siding who sold Dad on the idea that Artie was a bad influence on Pete. Meanwhile, another supervillain was on the loose. Papercut, a seventh-grade samurai who vowed revenge after being faced by Pete.
You have no idea what you have just done!
And once Artie was out of the picture, our world crisis officially began.
Fungus Lick. He's as gone as yesterday.
Chew foil, Papercut!
Let's cut to the chase, Dinner Mint. You owe me a rock, paper, scissors rematch.
We can play from now until doomsday, but I'll still throw scissors.
I wonder if Mr. Swan will help you change your mind. No? How about Mr. Sharp?
Chase the tap, you sicko!
Artie! Very clever. But you know I'll be back. Next time, I'll be laminated.
Yeah, well, Artie will be back too, you toner breath.
But would Artie be back? Pete didn't want to panic yet. First, he had to get some answers.
All I know is that he wanted me to drop him off at the county line.
What?
Well, I'm as surprised as you, son. You know, he told me... Well, he told me he wanted to get on with his life. You know, settle down.
You're lying!
Maybe he just wants to spend time with, you know, people his own age.
I don't know what's going on here, but I'm gonna find him!
The search began with an all-points bulletin on Wart Radio.
He was last seen wearing flammable pajamas and an ankle bracelet with the name Hacksaw on it.
Ellen and I raised money for the mutant hunt by selling Artie merchandise, while Mom released Artie's favorite smell, tire air, to lure him back. If that didn't work, Pete was banking on the Artie light.
Hang on, Artie. I'll find you.
Meanwhile, Dad tried to be the strongest dad in the world, hoping he could be his son's new superhero.
I guess I won't be needing that wheelbarrow anymore, huh?
Solid. Never needs painting. Will last.
But it wasn't long before adults realized that even though Artie was gone, his spirit was stronger than ever.
What is this, son?
It's an Artie action land canoe.
Not even a dent.
It's got a 200-mile radius. If he's out there, he'll see it.
Come home, Artie.
The cabin boy, the cabin boy. Mr. Bug? Hello, Mr. Buggy. Do you know that song?
Don, we got a problem. His powers are stronger than I thought.
The kids love him.
Oh. Not for long.
What are you gonna do?
Don't worry. Just take care of the light, and I'll do the rest.
20 watt? My son will be onto this in a second.
Oh, don't worry. It'll throw just enough light to fool him. Now, tell me where you left Artie.
I don't feel right about this.
No pressure, Don. I mean, if winning back your son isn't that important to you, then that's okay. Really.
Well, good night, Mr. Bug.
McFlemp's diabolical plan to brainwash Artie into being an adult began the next morning.
Hello, Artie!
Hello, sighting man.
How's every little thing?
Pipe.
Pipe! All right, that's great. Or should I say, pipe? Yeah. Look, Artie, I know we've had our differences in the past, but now I'm on your side. Mm. Oh, I know how hard it is to be going back and forth on your future, trying to switch horses midstream. That's why I'd like to be your friend and offer you a job.
It's all right. Too busy, too dang busy. Occupado.
Oh, no pressure, Artie. But if you act now, I'll throw in a free pair of slacks.
Whoa! Whoa! Of the permanent press variety?
As permanent as the stars.
Woo! Call me a truck and slap me till Wednesday.
You're a truck, Artie. You're a truck.
Well, what do you know? Hey, kids, your old pal Artie's on TV.
The adultification of Artie had begun, and it wasn't pretty.
How strong is our new Prep Star Super Sighting? Its twin polymer coating stands up to hail, heat, and even a full-grown man running into it repeatedly at full speed.
Strong as Kansas.
There you have it.
Artie, what are you doing?
It was as if Artie had run over Pete's heart with a backhoe. Mm. He had sold out to the enemy.
Mm. You too will enjoy the feeling of the pleasure ridges.
I'm sorry, Pete.
Out there in the real world, a man's got to make a living, son.
It was a victory for adults everywhere, as well as one scab-encrusted kid, Paper Cut. He knew that with Artie gone for good, Pete was as good as gone.
Ashes to ashes, pulp to pulp.
He was once a superhero who fought for kids everywhere. But after being brainwashed and broken by supervillain McFlemp, the only thing Artie fought for now was a sale.
Morning, ma'am. I'm here to talk to you about the miracle of aluminum siding.
With Artie out of the picture, the International Adult Conspiracy began their crackdown.
Ah, Wellsville.
We are finally free.
Don't pressure, son.
I think he knows what to do.
McFlemp was in charge now, and he wouldn't stop until the memory of Artie went up in flames.
What a purge of the poison that was Artie.
Seemed unreal. Wasn't this where Artie jumps in and saves the day? Where was he?
Ah! Pink on the inside, crisp and rooty on the outside. Just the way we like them in America.
It was a friendship that was supposed to last forever. But the Artie that Pete once knew no longer existed. Now the only thing left to say was goodbye.
Well, well, well. Like pages on a pad, we always wind up together.
Why don't you just lay off, paper cut?
Isn't that cute? Now the girls are fighting your battles.
What do you want, you fiber-licking blowhole?
A rematch. Rock, paper, scissors. This time, you're gonna lose. No, not now. Friday, I want the whole school to watch you lose.
You're gonna throw a rock, right?
He's just a stupid mutant. Who cares if he wins?
Yeah. Take a dive. Don't get cut.
Hey, Pete. You gonna show that paper cut kid a thing or two?
Yeah, my wrist when I lose.
What, you gonna give in? Hey, that doesn't sound like the Pete Wrigley I know.
That's because I'm not.
Hey, son, you want me to show you some jujitsu, you know, I picked up in the army?
No, Dad.
I know you miss Artie, but I can be your superhero.
Dad knew if Pete took a dive the next day, he'd be sunk forever.
Are you happy? You got the son you always wanted.
I just wanted us to get closer. I didn't think it would come to this.
22 hours! Lights out!
Maybe Dad couldn't be Pete's superhero, but if he got lucky, he could find someone who was.
Remember, if all else fails, he loves the smell of tire air.
And armpit sounds. He says it reminds him of his mother.
Check.
Morning, Don! Finally hauling that thing to the dump?
No, McFlimp. I'm gonna bring Artie back.
Oh, Wrigley, what are you talking crazy?
Get out of the way, John. No pressure.
You'll never find him.
I'll find him, all right.
Kifa,
Please come in. Come to Gruba, as they say in the country. Hey, everybody! It's the Kleinmarkers!
Dad tried through the night to call Artie, but it was useless. All Dad could do was watch the light fade out, the dawn fade up, and his hopes of saving Pete's spirit disappear forever.
If all else fails...
Thank God it's Friday!
Now, a little insect problem, do ya? Pusus!
Dad did the best he could. But the smell of tire air couldn't hide the stench of defeat.
Sorry, son.
Ah, it's repulsive.
Artie! Artie!
Yet strangely compelling.
Artie, it's me, Don! Don't you remember?
Hey, buddy, buddy.
There's no returns on sighting once it's already on the house.
Oh, you're not a salesman! No, you're Artie, the strongest man in the world. Pipe. Oh, where's Pete when I need him?
Pete? Pete?
Don't you remember Pete? He's in trouble and he needs you.
Pete. My little Viking. Trouble?
Pow! Indeed, Bazoom! I'm quite large again, Pappy! Onward!
Doomsday morning. We all turned out to see Pete off into oblivion.
Throw rock, Pete. You can do it.
Yeah, still be your friends.
Yeah.
Let's get this over with.
Well, well. Pete Wrigley. Thanks for coming.
You want me to help?
No. I've got to do this alone.
Paper beats rock. Rock beats scissors. Scissors beat paper. You lose, you live. Say, why don't I spot you? I'll throw first. Let's see. What shall it be? Oh, I know. Paper.
What is it that makes a superhero? Is it muscles of steel? The ability to see through brick walls? To turn yourself into a human butane torch? Or is it smaller? Like with Artie. A way of looking at the world and making everything in it a little bit stranger and a little bit better.
Suborbital meteor! What? You can't throw that!
We could all see it. The power that made Artie Artie had been passed along to my brother Pete.
Meteor melts rock, crushes scissors, and burns paper. You lose, you cheese log!
You! I warned you what would happen!
Go ahead, paper cut. I'll never cave.
And as the power surged through Pete, it started to surge through the other kids, too.
You better have a piece of paper for me. I throw a volcano. Covers rock, melts scissors, and burns paper.
Monsoon mashes paper.
Dune buggy, it crushes paper.
No! No! I'm paper
Yeah.
Artie, you should have been there. I crumpled paper cut. It was great. It was like you were there with me. I could feel you there. Where were you? What happened to you? Artie? What is it?
Well, I had a thing I did. You and me for years.
Artie had something to tell Pete. It wasn't just the story of being tricked by Dad or hired by McFlemp or working for 10% commission. It was the story of a superhero and a kid who ruled at dodgeball, waltzed the lunar landscape, and beat up the Atlantic Ocean. Until one day, the kid finally learned all there was to learn from his friend. And it was time for the superhero to move on.
Not the same. And you are a different Viking now. Yes, I have to go.
No!
Yes. Everything you need to learn is in here. Out there is some boy who needs me. He's small. He's puny, like he were.
But Artie, you're my best friend.
I always will be, my little Viking.
But will I ever see you again?
Worry not, boy. Worry not. For I am Artie, the strongest man.
I'll leave the light on for you.
You know, son, I'm going to miss that mutant.
Was Artie gone for good? I guess we couldn't know, but one thing was for sure. A part of Artie would always be with us, watching over us, like the heroes in our dreams, like the stars in the sky.
So you said.